Once we understand that a pair of structures are not the same, that is, that they're isomers, we'd like to know how those isomers are related to one another, and this flowchart is a convenient way for you to systematically identify the relationship of some pair of molecules. So the key thing is, we're making a comparison, and it's a comparison between a pair of isomeric structures. The first question we ask is, are they symmetry related, and what do we mean by that? We mean that is there any operation, a translation, a rotation, a reflection, any operation that we can do to one structure to make it superimpose, bond for bond, atom for atom, on the other structure? If the answer is yes, we have to ask ourselves another question. And the question deals with, how is it that we can bring those two molecules into superposition? Can we do it by only a rotation and a translation? If it's only a rotation and translation that brings one molecule into the other, then those two structures aren't different at all. In fact, we're back to that same old question, the same or not the same. They're the same. We didn't answer the question right the first time. They're homomers. So if it turns out that the structures are related not by a rotation and a translation, but requires a reflection, those molecules, that pair of isomers, are enantiomers. Back up to the top, if we had answered that first question, no, the molecules are not symmetry related. Nothing I can do, no symmetry, translation, rotation, reflection, can make one molecule superimpose on the other. Then I need to ask this next question, do they have the same bonding connectivity? If the answer is yes, we conclude they're diastereomers. If the answer is no, we conclude they're constitutional isomers. Let's put this to work with some relatively straightforward examples. So in the first case, we're dealing with trans and cis butene. Trans and cis butene cannot be made to superimpose by any action of rotation, reflection, or translation. So we get to the first question and the answer is no, and we have the same connectivity, so they must be diastereomers. In the next case, we're dealing with a molecule that has a relationship that shows an inversion of configuration at one of the stereocenters. If you were to assign R and S, you would conclude that there's been an inversion of configuration in this particular stereocenter. So these trans and cis diols must be diastereomers, and how could we conclude that based on the flowchart? Well, we would realize that there's nothing you can do with a symmetry operation. You can't translate, you can't rotate, you can't reflect the molecule on the right into the molecule on the left. But they do have the same connectivity. So once again, they must be diastereomers. Two different ways to recognize these molecules as diastereomers would be to assign R and S configurations and see that one of those stereocenters has inverted, or to use the flowchart and realize that the two molecules can't be made to superimpose by any action of translation, rotation, or reflection. What about in the case down here, we have two trans diols, and the molecule on the left, we see that it has RR configuration, and the molecule on the right has SS configuration. All of the configurations have inverted. We guess they're enantiomers. And that's actually true. Our flowchart would say, hey, there is a way to make the molecule on the right superimpose on the molecule on the left. It's not by a translation, or it's not by a rotation, but it's by a reflection. You've probably already picked up that there's a reflection plane that takes every single atom and finds a partner equidistant from the plane. So we see that translation of each atom through the plane finds a partner equidistant from the original atom to the plane. So we conclude that there's a reflection symmetry that relates those two. To follow our flowchart, there is a symmetry that relates the molecule on the left and the molecule on the right, and that symmetry happens to be a reflection. We could not rotate, or we could not translate and get these two molecules to superimpose. They're enantiomers. In the case on the right, the lower right-hand corner, if we were to assign configurations, we see that these are the same molecule. That is, they have the same configuration and they have the same constitution, so they're just the same molecule presented in a slightly different way, we could rotate the molecule on the left and then translate it, and it would superimpose. And so by the actions of rotation and translation, we can make them superimpose their homomers. A simple way to see how we would rotate would be to draw an axis through the center of that five-membered ring and rotate by 108 degrees, that's the angle of the pentagon, and we would move this hydroxyl group into a position that is here, which is equivalent to the location of the hydroxyl group on the other molecule. And the same goes for this hydroxyl group. Upon rotation, it would occupy that equivalent position.